Thank you so much for joining us this evening. My name is Matthew Compton, and I have the pleasure of directing Bells of the Cascades and for two nights, the Melodic Men as well. It is a joy to have Melodic Men here all the way from Florida. It's a very short flight, as you can imagine, but it's been a fabulous weekend working with them, and we hope you have a great evening just sitting back and enjoying and having fun with us. I'm gonna pass it to Mike.
Hey! sorry, I have to take advantage of this because I feel like God when I have a big microphone and low voice. So, we are the Melodic Men. My name is Joe. This is Tristan. We'll go through our story as we play different pieces for you. But to start it out, does anyone know what a melodic is, first of all? Has anyone seen this before? Oh, clapboard. Great. So it's basically, if a keyboard and a harmonica had a baby, it would be a melodica. Because on the outside, it looks like a keyboard, but if you touch it, it doesn't make any sound. Like, you just touch the keys. Okay, you don't like that.
Okay,
if you blow, it also doesn't make any sound. So you have to blow and press it at the same time. Because there's little reeds on the inside that vibrate. So we'll talk about it more, but before that, here's some Mozart.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. So my name is Tristan, like Joe already said. A little bit about where we started with this instrument. We started off playing these plastic instruments on the street, and we were playing at Pike Place Market, which I'm sure a lot of you guys know, in Seattle. And the goal was just to grab people's attention as forcefully and as aggressively as possible. So that's why we do this, I guess. But so we loved playing Mozart on the street, and that was very popular. We also ended up doing lots of videos, putting lots of videos online of us playing classical music, some video game music, Disney music, and you know, we're going to go through a lot of that now. And this next piece is the Nutcracker that Joe reduced from 2 hours to 2 minutes. So hey, for best man. So it's very efficient and emotionally extreme, as everything is with us, I suppose. And when we last performed this, we played this on a Holiday Pops concert with the Atlanta Symphony and the West Virginia Symphony, and all we did was play this and like slight right or whatever, but we were dressed up as elves, so I want you to imagine that, and you know, the shoes ringing, you know, and we had everything, candy canes, stockings, and hats, this is really the whole deal, so yes, unfortunately we didn't bring them today, but next time maybe. Here we go, Nutcracker. Mysterious sort of second melody, and then later there's you'll feel a fight kind of in the section, and he labels it fierce, which is an unusual name, unusual word to relate with bells, but we can try to be fierce if we can. And so it's just a really phenomenal piece, and we are honored that this is actually the world premiere weekend of this piece. So this is Bulwarkana by Alex Ebert. Incredibly honored to be given the opportunity to premiere that piece, so thank you, Alex. We actually have a couple of his ringers from his group down in LA who have joined us for this concert, so they'll be able to go tell him whether we did it right or not. The next piece we are going to do is called Solace, and it was commissioned by Bells of the Cascades in honor of their former director, David York, and his late partner, Chris. Chris passed away a couple years ago from ALS, and so BOC wanted to honor David and Chris with a piece, and so they commissioned a piece and learned a little bit about David and Chris's relationship and learned a little bit about their son, and I came up with Solace, and so please enjoy Solace. Thank you.
on? No? Hey! Okay, great. So, we are going to do a little bit of two hands music right now. You see, we're playing with one hand most when we stand up, because obviously you can't do that. So, we are going to be playing a little arrangement that I made of Batman versus Superman. And who are you, Joe?
I'm Superman.
So I'm the Bat, so good luck. See you later.
We thought it was very reminiscent of old video games, like Mario and Zelda, things like that. So we're going to play a little medley, a little Super Mario medley, of all the tunes from Super Mario, from Super Nintendo, and it's just really fun and reminiscent. So here you go. Thank you.
So as my inner 12-year-old continues to come out, we'll do another video game medley. Legend of Zelda, well, video game music in general, has some of the most catchy and memorable melodies, and it's generally super simple melodies that are just played on repeat for minutes at a time. But it creates such nostalgia, and video game music evokes such a character and a feeling that some of the music doesn't quite convey as well. But to me, Legend of Zelda is a game that's personally super important to me because I've played it since I was a small child and still play. And a lot of the music just goes through a variety of different ideas and everything, and Joe's fabulous arrangement of the Legend of Zelda, you'll feel all the different pieces from the majestic main theme to the little Kokiri elves running around in their green tunics to dragons and the desert, and it's just a lot of fun. So this is The Legend of Zelda, and then after we play this, we're going to take about a 10-minute animation. just ran away, but I wanted to thank Kyle Johnson and Joe Buono for playing a four-hand piano part. Stressful job of being a page turner. If you've never been a page turner, it's hard. Welcome back. The next piece we're going to play is called Reverberations, and Elisa, there, commissioned me to write a piece for her mom, and her only requirement was, I'd like you to make her cry. I hope that I don't generally make people cry, but that's what I was given, so I worked with it. So the idea of reverberations was to see how many different effects you can make with bells that are a little bit out of the norm. We have a lot of the standard techniques, but I wanted to see how to adapt them and mix different sounds and different timbres with the instrument. So this is reverberations. music connects us in such a unique way. It's interesting to see the interactions and relationships that you build with the people around you, and how their relationship with you impacts your lives. I am impacted by these vendors' lives, and they're in touch with me every weekend. We build a connection, and I get the pleasure to write pieces for them, which is an honor. We get to make stunning music with guest musicians, and truly phenomenal guest musicians at that, which is a joy. But it's also interesting just to see the interactions that you unexpectedly come across. And one of those relationships is that of one of my old college roommates, Jacob Erdman, who I composed the next piece with. We were only roommates for about a semester, our last semester at Concordia University, Wisconsin. We both graduated early. But for the first 3 years prior to that, we just became best friends. We became super close, and we started writing music together because we were bored. And so we wrote a couple pieces, and then we wrote Rhapsody in D-flat minor, and it took a life of its own. A rhapsody is a virtuosic composition that goes through a variety of different ideas and variations that intertwine and go in and out of each other. And so it's a tour de force, and so I hope you enjoy Rhapsody in D-flat minor. Thank you.
Good luck.
Some people won't think Malacca can sound beautiful, and they're probably right. we'll find out. Oh, so this thing that we started about 3 years ago, I mean, it was really just a joke. Like, I found a Malacca on my grandpa's couch, literally, and we started playing together. And things just organically spiraled to crazier and crazier. Like, this year, we've been to Lithuania and South Korea playing concerts and these things. And we went to South Korea. They said, well, we're actually really into American Hollywood films, so could you please play Queen's Bohemian Rhapsody? Because that just came out at the time. And we're like, all right. So here's Bohemian Rhapsody.
All right.
Thank you.
profoundly beautiful music, and one of my favorite things about every video that we do or post on Facebook or YouTube or whatever, we go really in depth with the score and we really look at, you know, what's going on, and we learn so much about the music, and so it's just, we become closer to every piece that we play, including the next piece we're going to play with the bells. They're just awesome. They're so good. I had literally never heard of a melodica until I saw their videos, and they're just unbelievable musicians on top of being just fun. Their nuances of musicianship with a toy instrument is really impressive. Unfortunately, we are at our final piece of the concert, and it's called Invictus. And when we started talking about this project about a year ago, I discovered there is a surprising lack of repertoire for bells and melodica for whatever reason. And so I was like, well, I'm going to write one that's specifically for this concert. And so this involves an original piece for bells and melodica. And Invictus just seems unconquerable, and it's just been a truly phenomenal process to work with these wonderful gentlemen who have taken a lot of time to learn the music and work with us, and it's just been phenomenal. So I want to thank you all so much for coming. I want to thank Rose City Park United Methodist Church for hosting us, for our fabulous AV and building hosts. It has just been a joy to play in this beautiful acoustic, feast. It's just so lively in here. It's lovely. I'd like to thank you all for taking the time to come and listen to us. It gets really boring to play week after week to a wall, so thank you for filling that wall for us. I'd like to thank the Melodica Men especially for taking this time to be with us and really, really just making this journey so phenomenal and enhancing our performance even more. So thank you guys very much. At the end of our concert, if you have any questions, I'll let you take a look at the instruments. Please feel free to participate in what I call the handbell petting zoo and take a look at our instruments and meet our ringers and other musicians. I thank you so much again for joining us this evening, and this is Invictus. Thank you. said that. There. If you came to our spring concerts last year with Bells and Sound, you would have heard a really fun arrangement of Carmen Fantasy. It's their fault. It's a phenomenal, truly engaging arrangement where, like the Nutcracker, Joe managed to condense an entire opera into about 3.5 minutes. And you get the entire flavor of the opera from beginning to end. This has just been such a joy and honor to stand in front of all these musicians and conduct them and work with this and see this project come to life. Malachi and I have been talking for quite a bit and just chatting and then dreaming up this concert that has finally come to reality and unfortunately an end. So, without further ado, please enjoy our encore, Carmen Fantasy. Thank you. all so much for joining us. Have a great evening. We'll see you at a future concert. Thanks so much.